So this is our last lesson, probably. I hope I will finish this lesson today. But I am not sure because there are many movie clips. It is the most entertaining part of the class, probably.
Good.
The miracle of the cinema, the miracle of cinema and hope. The miracle of cinema and hope. I want to show a movie clip before starting this topic. This is the Shawshank Redemption. Do you know this movie? Shawshank Redemption. It was about the prison life. There was a guy whose name is Andy. Andy was put into the hall. He was supposed to be criminal, but probably he is an innocent person. He was an accountant before the prison. He had a job. And in prison life, he was developing some tactics to manage the prison life. Okay? He was dealing with art, he was dealing with different activities, and he had hope. But other prisoners don't have so much hope. And there is an encounter between the prisoners and the Andy, who was into the hall for 1 month, probably. I mean cell, put into cell rather than hall. Because, you know, sometimes when you make a fault, you can, you know, put into the cell, isolated area.
Open the door. Open it up. Dufresne, open this door. Turn that off. I am warning you, Dufresne. Turn that off. Dufresne.
You're mine now.
They got 2 weeks in the hole for that little stunt.
On your feet!
Hey, look who's here.
Maestro.
Hey. And you couldn't play something good, huh? Hank Williams or something?
They broke the door down before I could take requests.
Was it worth it? 2 weeks in the hole?
There's no such thing as easy time in the hole.
That's right, a week in the hole is like a year.
Damn straight.
I had Mr. Mozart to keep me company.
So they let you tote that record player down there, huh?
He's in here. In here. That's the beauty of music. They can't get that from you. Haven't you ever felt that way about music?
I played the mean harmonica as a younger man. Lost interest in it, though. Didn't make much sense in here.
Here's where it makes the most sense. You need it so you don't forget.
Forget?
Forget that there are places... stone, that there's a... there's something inside that they can't get to, that they can't touch. It's yours.
What are you talking about?
Hope.
Hope. Let me tell you something, my friend. Hope is a dangerous thing. Hope can drive a man insane. It's got no use on the inside.
Better get used to that idea.
Like Brooks did?
Okay. As you see, the reason why he was put into hole was the resistance of him to some rules of the prison. He was turning on the music, and he was relaying the music to other prisoners who were in the garden, and they were listening to music. It was forbidden to listen to the music. And after getting out of the hall, they got together at the lunch, and they were talking about the meaning of the hall. And as you see, Andy said that he could manage while he was in the hall, because he was listening to Mozart's music inside him. Remember that in the beginning of the lessons and before weeks, we were talking about duration. There was a time inside us. Everybody's duration is different from each other, and we were carrying out this duration inside us. And this duration is very different from other people's duration. He was listening to music. He was listening to Mozart. Mozart with heart and with brain, you know, there is a combination between them. So nobody cannot touch this area, he was saying this. But black person, was against Andy, and he was saying that, what are you talking about? Hope is dangerous thing. Andy is against red. By saying hope, without hope you cannot manage the life. Hope is a requisite to do many things. Is a requirement doing many things. Is really hope dangerous? If you ask this question to Red says that hope is a dangerous thing, because if you have some hopeful feelings inside the prison, you can face some dangerous things. Okay, so you should depress, you should suppress your hopeful feelings. You should suppress. Okay. Yes, actually, hope is very dangerous. In somewhat, hope is very dangerous. Why do you think that hope is dangerous? Do you have any idea? Yes, hope is dangerous.
I think there's two ways. It can be dangerous or not. It can be dangerous when it puts you in some situation that you want to believe in something that potentially it can be real. So it's like you are turning around. For example, you want to achieve a goal that normally you are not able to achieve it. Like when we look for reality, you can do it, but you have hope. That's mean that hope is losing you, is making you to lose your time by doing that stuff, because normally eventually you can do it. So in that side, hope can be dangerous or not good.
Mm-hmm.
But in the good side, hope can help you to have motivation
mm-hmm.
to accomplish something that you mm-hmm. can do, that mm-hmm. is normal for you. So you need hope to motivate you. That is my point of view.
Mm-hmm. Do you have an idea? Okay. Maybe you can express yourself later. As you remember the movie, because you have watched this movie, in the ending scene, Andy gets out of the hall, gets out of the prison. Okay, he escapes from the prison. in 30 years, as far as I remember, in 30 years, he tried to manage to escape from the
prison.
And he was using a small device.
P-Camel.
Hmm. Yeah, P-Camel. And he was, you know, carrying the wall. He was taking the stones and soil, and he was putting this soil inside the packet, and he was, you know, throwing the soil around the garden. So in 30 years, he had an opportunity to make a crack in the hole. So he escaped from the prison. But other prisoners didn't feel such a hope. He had a hope to get away from the prison. Andy makes a difference in his life by hope. But, you know, Red, the black person, was living in the prison for a long time. And when he was young, he committed a crime, and he was imprisoned. He was imprisoned person, and now he is old, but he has not so much hope. He doesn't have any hope to manage inside the prison and outside. Remember, in the movie, he has a chance to get away from the prison.
Yeah.
but he didn't manage to adapt himself to the life. So he remembered that while he was in prison, Andy made a promise to him. If you get out of the prison, you can come to this place and you can find some material and you can find me. Okay? By this hope, by this promise, Red may find a chance to live in the world. Okay? So hope. Hope is dangerous. Why? Because you can face many dangerous things by hope. But on the other hand, if you take risk, you can manage to do many things. Okay? That is why hope is a double sword. There are some negative sides and positive side, but sometimes we think that negative side is a bad thing to us, but without negative side, you cannot do many things. Without negative side, you cannot step another level, okay? This is, you know, you are playing computer games. I used to play computer games. And you are facing many dangerous things, and sometimes you are getting into hopeless area, but you try to handle with these difficult activities, but in the ending, seeing you can pass over another step. So by watching this scene, we can face a double sword of the feature of hope. On the one hand, hope can be creative. On the other hand, the hope can be dangerous. And if we want to create a new thing, we have to have some kind of hope. Okay? Without risk, without danger, we cannot create change in our life. So that is why Andy patiently and insistently deals with escaping from prison, whereas Red has been staying in the prison for a long time. So hope is a miracle of cinema, as you see in the movie clip. So even in the worst conditions, hope can occur any time, any moment. But in science books, in social science books, in humanity books, In philosophy, you cannot find this miracle. Everything has to be rational. Everything has to be, you know, in order. But in cinema, in art, you should try new things, and you should have hope in order to change your life and change the world and change the people's life. And hope can occur anytime. Miracle can occur anytime. So now let's look at another scene. Let's have a look at another scene.
Before we pass to the other scene,
okay.
I would like to make an observation. I'm just thinking.
Mm-hmm.
You know the scene of the where they were dining together, eating, where the guy was telling his fellow inmates that he about his hope and all those things, and what's his name? Red?
Red, yes.
Yeah.
Black.
And, yeah. And Red says he sort of wants to make him to give up from his mission.
Mm-hmm.
So there, I sort of feel there is a kind of white supremacy in that scene. Like, if you see, they use a black guy
mm-hmm.
and a white guy in that scene. The white guy is the one that is championing strength, and the black guy is the one that is championing sort of weakness. Like, yeah, he doesn't want to step out from his box. He doesn't want to do something different. He just wants to stay in his comfort zone. And yeah, the white guy is the person that is strong and he can take over any difficulty, and he's the one that has hope. He's one that, yeah, and I just saw that thing in that scene. I don't know if it's just my observation.
Yes, it is a debatable issue. Maybe in an unconscious way, the movie directors or the novelists are writing or directing the movies in accordance with the wills of the white people's representation. There was a hero who was white, and another person is subordinated by the white person. And when you compare white and black, the black person is low level of courage, something like this. But when you watch this movie from the starting until the end, you watched, I think you cannot get some impression in accordance with this comment. Because the story, you know, is being told by Red. Red tells the story. So actually Red tries to convince us to believe this story. If you tell any story, actually you are a kind of hero. We are seeing the events in the eyes of the Red. And the second thing, Red was the leader, a kind of leader in the prison. He was governing everything. He was governing. For example, the Andy wants to find the pick hammer. He wants to find the pick hammer, but Red finds it. Red finds every stuff in the prison, and he was commanding everything, okay, every person. Red was the leader in the prison. And that is why I am not sure. But you didn't watch the movie, that is why you can get some impression from this scene. But probably this week you should watch this movie. You can find it easily. And it is a very famous movie. Everyone that watch this movie can be impressed the technique, the cinematic technique, and also the story, the content. Did you like it?
Yeah, I liked it. I watched it 2 years ago, and it's in my computer, I think.
In Turkish, in Turkish, Esaretin Bedeli. When you write Esaretin Bedeli, you can watch it.
What's the name in English?
English, Shawshank Redemption.
Shawshank Redemption.
So there is no correlation between the Turkish title and English title, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But I don't know how to translate it. Because Shawshank is, you know, prison. Redemption is salvage. So, okay, maybe kaçış, maybe Shawshank'tan kaçış. Maybe you can translate it.
Turkish dublage is
Israeli. Yeah. In cinema, the movie in English, when you go to the cinema, it has another name in Turkish.
Let's have a look at another scene. It is about from dying. It is a scene from Dying Young. The name, the title of the movie, Dying Young. It was made in 1991. The director Joel Schumacher.
German.
But it is not German movie. It is American movie. Probably his origin was German, but he immigrated to America. You know, America is immigration country.
There is no America.
Mexican. This melting pot. But I think America is very successful for melting pot.
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah. So you can face a well-educated and rich person. Rich person. But he is cancer sick. And takes chemotherapy medicine. So he hires Hillary to be his living caretaker. You know, living caretaker. Caretaker means she's, you know, living there. So as you guess, they fall in love. Classic scene. Victor, the guy's name is Victor. Victor hides his use of morphine, you know, hides to kill the pain, because he is using morphine to kill his pain. He doesn't want to take treatment. Why? Because he explains that he wants quality in his life rather than taking the medicine. Okay, he makes a choice between them. Which one is ethical, we don't know. And this is the final scene.
My trick.
No more tricks, Hillary. And no more hospitals. I don't want to hurt you anymore. I never wanted to hurt you.
No, you are the first person
that I was sick.
Then where are you going? You gonna hide somewhere till you die? I can't let you do that, Victor. I can't let you give up.
I gave up when you left me.
No, you didn't. You gave up before I left.
Hillary, I don't want to be sick anymore.
I know. That's why I want you to come back with me.
I can't.
Why?
I can't.
I'll drive you to the hospital. I'll carry you if I have to.
I cannot do it.
Why?
I can't do it.
Tell me why.
Because.
What?
of hoping. It hurts to be around you, Hillary, because you make me want to live so much.
Then live, Victor. You don't know what's gonna happen. You don't know when you're gonna die. Nobody does. But we have right now. So fight, Victor. Live with me. Live with me.
Look at you. Yours. Young. And so beautiful and smart. You can do anything. Why do you want to do this?
Because I love you. If you come back with me to the hospital and fight for us, if you fight for us, I will never leave you, Victor. But you have to fight. And if you get well, when you get well, I'll be there with you. And if you die, hold your hand. And the last thing you ever see will be me, because I love you.
Yes, the ending scene. The end. Okay, what do you think? I think there is a similarity between between movie clips. Fear of hoping. And Victor wants to run away. Victor wants to run away and admits that he is afraid of hoping. The last frame of the movie shows Victor and Hillary leaving the home. And we see a small picture. Adam and Eve, you know, in the window. Why does the movie director want to show this painting? Actually, Gustav Klimt's painting. Gustav Klimt's Adam and Eve. Is it coincidence?
What painting are you talking about? The
Adam and Eve.
No, like in the movie, you said there is a. He shows a painting. The director shows a painting. What painting is that?
Adam and Eve
painting. I mean,
was it in the movie?
Yeah, it
I
is
didn't pay attention.
The name of the painting is Adam and Eve.
I didn't see it.
Really?
I only saw a painting in the last scene.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I didn't pay attention to your presentation.
Yes. Okay, this.
Ah.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Is it coincidence? Coincidence? And the movie is ending like this. And we don't know what the future, the future brings to Victor and the woman, Hilary, sorry. We don't know the destiny of the Victory. Probably he will die, but we are not sure. But and the, at the end of the movie, you know, you see the painting, the picture, Adam and Eve. What represents it?
Can I make a comment?
Okay.
I think from the beginning, from when he said he wants to give up, it's in the nature of man that every human being is always in search of validation. Like we have something we want to do, and there are things we do not want to do. But what we want to do, we tend to suppress that feeling in order to seek validation from someone. Actually, we want to do it, but what we are portraying is something else. Like in the scene, he really doesn't want to go, but he also wants to stay. And what he really wants, and what I think he really wants, is to stay with the woman. So at that moment, he's seeking validation from this woman. He's seeking some sort of support from this woman. He wants to hear what the woman is going to say. And when he leaves and goes out and we see that picture of Adam and Eve, I think what the director is trying to say, I don't know if it's right to say, but every man needs a woman to complete him in some way, to make him a complete... every man needs a woman by his side to as a support, to give him that completion. I don't know how to word it, but that's...
Yeah, I got it.
That's what I have to say.
Yeah, it is kind of like in the scene, it was the lady's argument that prevailed, because she win. Like, okay, then we go to the hospital. So with the Adam and Eve, that's it is because in the history, it was Eve who brought Adam and convinced Adam to eat also the fruit.
Perfect comment.
Okay.
I am surprised.
The lady's...
Yes, you are right.
The lady's argument is... One, I mean, in the history of Adam and Eve, so in that scene, maybe he wanted to show that, okay, because the lady's... her argument will prevail, so... I don't know.
Actually, I am impressed. I am impressed from your comments. You can be right. Okay, good comments. And but I think we can agree at this point. Fear of hope. There is a fear of hope. Fear of hope. Love defeats fear of hope. Do you agree with me about this issue? We can have some differences. Actually, I agree with you about your comments, I mean. But the love between them defeats the fear of hope. Because there is some kind of hopeless feeling inside the victor, you know? And he doesn't want to encounter with the fear. He doesn't want to encounter with the fear. As you see, as you understand, there is contradiction feeling, contradictory feeling inside the victor. Maybe he doesn't want to, okay, get away from the house. And on the other hand, he would like to be complimented by the woman. Maybe he's looking for confirmation of the woman. But everybody has conveying some kind of contradictory feelings inside them. Probably the woman as well, you know, has conflictual feelings inside her. And sometimes we want to show another face, but our real feelings are hidden inside us. And maybe we believe in our real feelings, we want to believe in them, but we want these feelings to be confirmed by others. Okay, you are right. I actually agree with you. You are right. But nevertheless, as you see, there is a contradiction between hope and, you know, despair or unhopeless feelings. And at the end of the movie, we can feel that probably love will defeat the fear of hope. And whether or not Victor dies, nevertheless, their love will win. Okay, their love will. There can be hope in the life, even the under worst conditions. Even the under worst conditions, cinema can show us. You know, Victor is almost to die. He's taking medicine, he's taking chemotherapy, and he doesn't have any hope. But the woman wants to believe that probably, you know, Victor will live. We don't know. And she says that we don't know what the future brings. And even if you will die, I can hold your hand. This is another hope. You cannot give up your hope. No, you can support. You can support the lover of yours. This is another miracle, I think. Because she is young, she can give up this man. She can find another people. But she wants to resist these worst conditions. This is the miracle of cinema, I believe that. So you can find this miracle in the cinema. This is my comment. So I will show you another example. Remember we were talking about Plato's cave. And Plato's cave allegory was human condition. Okay? Human condition. So Red or other inmates or Victor actually was constructing their caves. Were constructing their caves, and they didn't believe in hope. But finally, hope wins unhopeful or hopeless feelings. All habits, customs, traditions, conventions, and ideologies mediate between us and being. I repeated myself again. We cannot see being. Cinema make visible things. This is one of the possibilities and contribution of cinema to us. If I make a sentence here, cinema teaches as a lesson of hope. A lesson of hope. What is it? Hope shows that there might emerge, cinema shows that there might emerge a hope even in the worst circumstances. There is a hope, a miracle, even in the worst conditions. And remember, I have showed a scene from Journey to Italy by Roberto Rossellini. And we were talking about this ending scene, and we said that love is an event which happened to us. Remember the ending scene? Journey to Italy, okay? A married couple visit Italy, and they try to reinvigorate their marriage because they are about to divorce. They are, they, but their trouble in their marriage. Why almost divorcing? A miracle happens. A miracle happens. In too short time, they notice their love. They notice their love. This miracle can occur at any moment in life, in cinema. But in philosophy, we cannot face any miracle. Okay? In philosophy, we cannot face any miracle. But in cinema, we can face miracles. And remember, I have showed another scene from Before Midnight. Do you remember this scene? The ending scene. There was a couple who were talking about the meaning of stories, and the husband, was reading a poetry, some kind of poetry to his wife, by saying that there was a time machine, you know, some kind of story. So you are waiting for the miracle. You are waiting for the miracle, and at the end of the movie, the wife joins the story, and we say that this is another love concept. And in too short time, miracle happens again, okay? So in the beginning of the lecture, I have shown a Turkish movie. I have shown a Turkish movie scene about the meaning of love and dearness. There was a separation between dearness and love. The woman with red scarf, something like this. In Turkish we are saying Al yazmalım, selvi boylum. There was a truck driver, you know, and there was a kid. And there was a struggle between the first husband and the second husband. And we were asking which one the woman would select between them. And the miracle happens and the woman chooses his second husband. She suppresses his deep feelings, passionate love. Rather than passionate love, she chooses dearness, which means making an effort in life. If any person makes an effort in life, you can choose him or her. Effort is the basic step in human life. This is the message of the ending scene. And she sides with dearness. She sides with effort, rather than passionate love. This is a choice. This is another hope. Okay? This is another hope. So, sometimes miracle is so unbelievable that we would like to believe this world, this life. We think unthinkable thing. We think unthinkable thing. What kinds of things? Resurrection, what does it mean? Do you know?
Bring back to life, come back to life.
No, resurrection means you are dying and you are resurrect.
Yes, coming back.
Okay. Come back to life. Yeah. Come back to life, sorry. I was hearing like combat. Sometimes, yeah. Eternal life, for example, eternal life. Reaching the edge of the universe. Reaching the edge of the universe. Is it possible? No, we don't believe in this kind of things, but in cinema, we can show the edge of the universe. Is it possible to get into computer life? Is it possible to, you know, to enter the computer life? And we don't believe these kind of things, but in cinema we see that there can be a possibility of getting into the computer life. But we are not sure whether or not in the future, probably you can be, you know, divided. Maybe there can be numerical algorithm inside you. You can maybe, we don't know. Maybe in the computer life, your algorithm combine and you can resurrect in the computer life. We don't know. But in the cinema, you can see this kind of ideas. And so I want to show another scene from Carlos Reygadas. Do you remember Carlos Reygadas? Silent Light, the beginning of the movie. There were some sounds coming from the forest, insects sounds, and there was a dark area, and it is opening itself.
Time image.
Yes, time image, you remember. Good. And this is the movie, Silent Light. And I would like to show the ending scene of the Silent Light. So this ending scene shows the unbelievable one, unbelievable thing. This is the husband, and this is husband's wife is dying, actually has died. And this is the husband's lover, the woman, husband's lover. Husband's lover enters the room. Watch out the camera movement, panning. And as you see, you cannot see the head of the woman. This is the geometrical frame, which means you cannot change the camera position. But the character enters the camera angle. Watch out the face of the dead woman. Maybe you can notice the change of the color of the face. Time image. Did you notice?
Yeah. She's getting red.
She's coming to back life. and she has resurrected. So this is the miracle, huh? This is the miracle of cinema. But if you believe these miracles, there can be a link with the world and you. You can believe in this world, you can believe in this life, you can link with the world. That is why Deleuze says that actually we don't need to know so much knowledge after that, after the Second World War. We need to believe in this world. We need to believe. Belief is the starting point after this step, after this Second World War, okay? So if you believe in some miracles, you can make a fork in your life. You can create new forks in your life. That is why. Remember I showed another scene which was related to the meaning of music, Three Colors Blue. The ending scene, three colors blue. And in this ending scene, there was some explanations of the music, I mean the meaning of the song. And in this song, it was saying that there were three things in your life: faith, love, and knowledge. I think knowledge. Another thing, knowledge? Probably. But among them, the best thing, one of the most important thing, is to believe in love. So, in Three Colors Blue, love is the highest point in life. Okay, and in this movie, actually the topic of the movie is love. And remember the seven dwarfs and Snow White. There is a tale. There is a fairy tale. Okay, fairy tale. Do you know fairy tale? Seven dwarfs and Snow White. Do you remember the topic of seven dwarfs and Snow White? There was a princess, and at the ending of the fairy tale, she dies, and prince comes to near her. He kisses her, and miracle happens. The princess came back to life. So I think it is similar to Seven Dwarfs and Snow White fairy tale, but characters are different, and you know there are two women there, and one of them is lover of the guy, and the other is the wife of the guy. Actually, the man likes both of them. But he has some contradictory feelings about them. And that is why he has some doubts, he has some troubles about their love feelings. Actually, you can make a separation between them, dearness and love concept. Dearness and love concept. The wife of him makes an effort in his life, okay? She struggles with many things. That is why probably he likes her. But on the other hand, he has a passionate love. He is looking for a passionate love. And he finds a woman. So he is divided. He is divided. And when the wife hears this event, I think he commits suicide, I am not sure. Because there was a raining, and he gets out of the car, he escapes from the car, and she runs away, and after a while, the man finds his wife under the tree. I think it is true. Yes. So, do you want to make a comment about this?
I want to ask a question.
Okay.
Why does the director want to show us, want to pass a message to us through something that in normal life is unrealistic? Like in our life, we know that yes, once you are dead, you're dead. Like there is no possibility of you coming back to life.
Mm-hmm.
But why will he want to try and pass a message through something that we all believe to be unrealistic?
First of all, I would like to say that the art or cinema is not a message. They don't have any information inside them. Art is a vibrational thing, and art, and particularly cinema, wants to show the infinite things or chaos in this artistic way. I mean, you are making visible some things which are invisible to us. Okay, there is eternal or infinite things, and you can construct art, and by art you are trying to visible the invisible things or unhurtable, or make them hurt unheardable, unspoken things, probably. So you cannot evaluate art as message. But there is a world view of directors. There is a world view that they tend to life in a particular way. And the director, in fact, wants to show that many people think the life given to us as it is. I mean, we accept life as it is. I mean, you don't interrogate the. You don't interrogate many things in the life. And you just believe in knowledge. This is empirical knowledge. You are collecting some data, you analyze, you are making analyze on this data. You are entering this data on the computer, and you are just speculating on this data. But beyond that, sometimes we have to use our intuition, okay? And intuition means that you don't need to know so much knowledge. Sometimes you have to pass the knowledge, and you have to try to understand some things in a different way, in artistic way. Even though we don't find any knowledge about the resurrection or coming back to life, nevertheless, we can make a link with the life and the world by showing some unthinkable things, and so we can have hope, some kind of hope about the life, about different life, different forms. From the beginning, I was talking about the different forms, different virtues, virtuality of the life. Remember that there is an actuality, present things, present moments, present area, present spaces. But on the other hand, there is an virtual area of life. Everything has a virtuality, its own virtuality. But this virtuality is the part of reality. Okay? They are just hidden in our sight or inside the stuffs. What does it mean? I asked a question to you before. What if you could have participated in this lesson? What could have you done if you had joined this lesson? There can be different possibilities of life, okay? Probably you could have gone to cinema, you could have gone to another class, you could have gone to theater, I'm not sure. There could have different possibilities in your life. But in actuality, you joined this lesson, joined the lesson, and other possibilities are, you know, have disappeared for the moment. But there could have different possibilities. Maybe in the life, we can believe in these possibilities. We can believe in this kind of possibilities, and we can make a choice between them. Many people are not aware of their choices, their preferences. They think that life is like this, as it is given to us, to them. Okay? They have granted the life. So this is a problematic situation. The problem is this. It is impossible to resurrect in the life, okay? But if we believe in some things, maybe there can be different possibilities. Let me give an example. In the mythology, there were different creatures, okay? Creatures. And you can say that, these creatures could have not been possible before and now and also after. But how do you know that these different creatures have been lived in another planet? Do you know all the planets in the world? Do you know all the planets in the world other than world? You can have idea some other planets in solar system, but we know that there are many planets in the universe, and maybe in a universe, this creature could be found in the future. So, how do you know that this creature cannot be available in different universe? Okay, everything can be possible. So before atom is the, we were thinking that atom is the smallest thing in the matter, but we understand that now subparticles are available under the atom, and we are talking about the quantum physics now. In quantum physics, indeterminacy is the basic principle of the matter, of the energy, indeterminacy. So, how can you determine some things in the life? And as Bergson and Deleuze said, universe is vibrational thing, and there is some membrane in the universe, and everything is in motion, and you can not determine many things when you don't have an idea about the future. Okay, indeterminacy is the principle of the life, probably. I hope you received your answer. And good. And and you know the Modern Times, Charlie Chaplin movie, 1960, 1936, Modern Times. Did you watch this movie, Modern Times, Charlie Chaplin? The topic of the movie is this. Charlie Chaplin was working in the factory. He was a worker. He was doing the same activities. He was working in the at the assemblage, yes.
Like this?
Yeah, I watch. Assemblage area. And but he doesn't like his work. He doesn't like his profession. And he is trying to find some tactics to get away from the work moment. His talent is based upon the music and dancing, actually, but he is not aware of his talents. And in the movie, over time, he faced another woman, a woman, and by this encountering, he understands that his talent is, you know, dancing and singing song. But he cannot make a success in his life, and final scene. See, the woman and the man, Charlo, is trying to do new things. There is a hope here. There is a road, which means on which you can make a travel in his life. And there is a dawn, you know, sun dawn, I think, dawn, yeah? Dawn, Shafak?
Horizon.
Huh?
Horizon.
Horizon, no, dawn. I think dawn, and hope continues. Despite everything, you should try, okay? And as you see, the woman is hopeless, but Charlo, you know, the guy, is doing the different things, you know, he's doing some stuff, he's trying to, you know, dealing with his shoes and socks, something like this. He doesn't care the unsuccessful attempts. This is a very important point, I believe that. And it shows us the hope feeling. And this is another movie, 400 Blows. Actually, this is the new wave film. In Turkish we are saying Yeni Dalga, French New Wave. After 1950s, I think, after New Realism movement in France, this new wave movement started, and there were different directors of this new wave movement. One of them is François Truffaut. François Truffaut, is it correct to pronunciation?
Yeah.
François Truffaut. And there were other directors like Jean-Luc Godard. Remember the cafe scene in which the prostitute and the philosopher was talking to each other, This is the another movie. There were different movies. So what is the topic? And there is a boy, a young boy, teenage boy, and he has a family problems. The mother doesn't care him. The father actually doesn't care him, and he tries to do new things in his life. He doesn't get some excitement in his life, and he has some suppressing feelings. And at the end of the movie, he was put into the confinement area, and dormitory. And the boys are playing football. And look at the ending scene.
Continue.
different, eh?
Mm-hmm.
So you are thinking while you are watching, because unexpected images you are facing, huh?
Especially at the hand, why you run under the the sea? I don't know why.
Probably the boy is asking you to help him. So maybe he is asking some question to you. What can I do now? What can I do now? I am here, and you don't have an idea what the future brings to child, to boy. And why does he go to the sea? Sea. What does it mean? Sea, road. He is escaping from the confinement area. It is a dormitory area. He has to do some kind different. Actually, he has to do some rules. Okay, he has to obey with rules of the confinement area or dormitory. But he's unhappy there, and he doesn't have any idea about what he will do in the future. But what he knows is to escape from this area. And he escapes. Camera follows him, pans, and finally he reaches the edge of the ocean, probably ocean rather than sea, I am not sure. And what is the meaning of sea? What is the meaning of ocean?
Freedom.
Yes.
Salvation.
Salvation, yes. Risk, taking risk. Because there can be dangerous creatures, or there can be that dangerous adventure on the ocean. Remember the remember Jack Sparrow, Caribbean pirates. Mm-hmm. Do you know this series?
Yeah.
Jack Sparrow was taking risk while he was making a journey on the ocean, and. I think there is a contradiction between land, soil, and ocean. Because ocean flows. You can create your own future.
Ocean also has so many dimensions. Over the ocean, under the ocean. But in the normal land, you have just one dimension. So it's kind of freedom.
Mm-hmm.
You can go everywhere that you want.
So I believe that when we look at this ending scene, there can be a hope. There can be a hope for the future of the teenage boy. That it is why the ending scene finishes near the ocean. And when the boy looks at us, the motion stops. The motion stops. But when the motion stops, does it mean that inner motion stops? Your inner motion continues. Your inner motion continues, even though the motion of the boy stops for a while. Okay? And this is one of the best ending of the movies, I think. Yes, I like this kind of endings. Otherwise, if the problem can be solved, what does it mean? It is catharsis. Catharsis. Do you remember? Catharsis. Everything. Catharsis, which means like salvation in the movie. You are discharging your energy. You are discharging your energy. And you cannot ask many questions after the movie. But after watching this movie, you have many questions inside your mind. Probably after the lesson, you will ask this question. What will happen to the child? Why does he run away from the dormitory? There are lots of questions. And hope. If you ask questions, it means that you can have hope. about the future. Okay? And this is the possibility of cinema. And the way to hope. And another thing,
Seninle yattığım bile. Tanrım. Daha genç olsaydım belki. Ama olmaması daha iyi. Bugün pişman olurduk.
Doğru. Pişman olurduk.
Giderken bizdeki eşyalarını al. İki gömleğin, 3 mendilin var bizde. Bir de donun var.
Alsın. Bir gün çocuklara verirsin.
Elveda.
Olgunlaşmıştı. Kininden tamamen kurtulmuştu. Evet. Mahit büyük bir devrim olacağını her zaman söylerdi. Uydu. Örgütlenerek, sakince olayları gözlemleyerek sendikalar kurmak ve gün gelip şartlar olgunlaşınca binlerce tembelin karşısında milyonlarca işçinin gücü eline alması ve sonunda hakim olması demekti. Adalet bu demekti. Şimdi Nisan güneşi olanca görkemiyle dört bir yana ışık saçıyor. Üretken toprağı ısıtıyordu. Her yerde tohumlar olgunlaşıyor, toprağı zenginleştiriyor. Işık ve ısıyla her yerde filizleniyor. Fısıldayan seslerin altında öz sular taşıyor. Tohumlar serpiliyor. Verimli doğanın... Daha sonra gittikçe toprağa yaklaşıyordu. Cana can katan o Nisan sabahında uçsuz bucaksız ovanın dört bir yanından derin bir uğultu yükseliyordu. İnsan bitiyordu topraktan. Gelecek yüzyılda ürün vermek üzere yavaş yavaş filizlenen, pek yakında yerküreyi sarsarak baş verecek olan kapkara bir insan ordusu boy atıyordu.
This is the terminal ending. Did you watch this movie? No. A nomadic worker, an unsuccessful struggle. The topic of this movie. The main issue is that it is an experience. The more you experience some things, the more you gain some new things, and in the future, you can have a possibility to reach your aims, but for the moment, in the present moment, you cannot find your reach. But it doesn't mean that in the future there will be different things. Okay. So this is the ending movie. There were workers and there was struggle between workers and the masters and the owners of the factories. And these miners lost their struggle, and the nomadic worker left the factory, and inner voice comes out. As you listen to inner voice by camera movement, and also when you are listening to this voice and watching the images, you can see the road. Road. There is a road in the future, and you don't know the future. Maybe you can be successful. Maybe you can be unsuccessful. You don't have an idea, but you should try. Remember the voice of the guy. He says that in the future, people will sprang, you know, will be sprung all around the world. And we, you know, we ekmek neydi ya? Seed. We will land the seed probably. Ekmek neydi?
Ekmek. Plant.
Ha?
Plant.
Plant, huh? We will plant the seeds of the people, and in the future they will sprang. Okay. This is another hope. So philosophy learns from cinema that there can be hope even under the worst conditions. Philosophy learns from the cinema. Cinema teaches hope lesson to philosophy. Remember, what is our lesson topic? The relationship between cinema and philosophy. What is the relationship between cinema and philosophy? We cannot claim that philosophy can dominate the cinema. On the contrary, cinema today can make a lesson, can give a lesson to philosophy. Okay, there is an interchange, there is an interrelationship between them, but nevertheless, today cinema makes a contribution to philosophy about hope lesson. By the way, by saying hope, I am not talking about mechanical perception or prediction. In many Hollywood movies, we predict many endings. This is a kind of catharsis, which means our expectation comes to realize. We relax and get away from the real life. Remember, I showed many movie clips. Iron Man 2, Spider-Man 2, you know, you expect many things. And you hope, you have hope that there will be a hero and heroes will save the child. I'm not talking about this hope, okay? I am not talking about this hope. What kind of hope we are talking? Do you have an idea?
The hope we've been talking about?
Yeah. What kind of hope I'm talking about? Even under the worst conditions, you should try. You should try. You can lose your effort for the moment, but it doesn't mean that in the future there will be different paths in your life. Okay? I'm not talking about the expectation will come to realize. In Hollywood movies, you expect that there will be hero, and hero will save everybody. I'm talking about this hope. This mechanical hope, mechanical. I'm talking about this, how can I say? This magical hope, probably.
A hope that has...
Unexpected
hope. That has two sides.
Yes. Okay. And I want to show you another movie clip. The movie's name is The Road. The Road. It was made in 2009. It is very impressive. And how can I say? It is very important movie. I like this movie. A man and his son struggle to survive after a global catastrophe. But we don't know the reason of the global catastrophe. It almost causes an extinction of human being. They scavenge for supplies. Scavenge for supplies, do you know the meaning? Scavenge. Yeah. Scavenge. Scavenge for supplies and avoid roaming gangs. There are some roaming gangs all around the world. Cannibalism is among the human being. Cannibalism is common. The man's wife loses her hope and walks into the woods. And we don't know the destiny of the woman in the movie. She has never been seen again. And let's have a look at the ending scene.
Thank you. man you're with. Father?
Yes. He was my papa.
Maybe you should come with me.
You're one of the good guys?
Yeah, I'm one of the good guys. Why don't you put that pistol away?
You're not supposed to let anyone take it from you. No matter what.
I don't want your pistol, I just don't want you pointing at me. So you got two choices here. You can stay here with your papa, or you can go with me. If you stay here, you need to keep off the road.
How do I know you're one of the good guys?
You don't. You'll just have to take a shot.
Have any kids?
Yes, we do.
Do you have a little boy?
We have a little boy and a little girl.
How old is he?
That's your age. A little older.
You didn't eat them?
No.
So, don't eat people?
No, we don't eat people.
And are you carrying the fire?
My what?
Carrying the fire.
You're kind of weirded out, aren't you, kid?
Well, are you?
Yeah, I'm carrying the fire.
And I can come with you?
Yes, you can.
Glad to see you. We were following you, did you know that? We saw you with your papa. I'm so lucky. I'm so worried about you. Now we don't have to worry about them. How's that sound? Is that okay?
Okay, it is long, but I don't want to cut the seconds. But I think the ending scene, and it is very impressive. Eh? Did you like it?
Yes. It was
unexpected. I was actually waiting for something bad to happen when the guy approached the kid, because you ran us through the story just now, saying there was a catastrophe and cannibalism and all that. And at the end, out of all those bad things that had happened, there is still an atom way of good inside. And it's shown to us that yes, there is hope. Yani, even after all the traumas he has gone through, the father struggled through that process, and the son also struggled through that process. But the father couldn't continue his war. Is ended there, and the boy now continues the legacy of his father. Even though they have fought a lot, now he has met someone that is going to take him to salvation, and this is actually a new beginning for this boy. Like a new chapter has been opened. He is now free from the past of what has happened before. I guess.
Okay. Take a shot, huh? Take a shot.
Yeah, you should take a shot.
Take a shot. You have two choices. One choice is to keep off the road. You can leave us. And the other choice is you can continue with us. And I think, do you want to make a comment or?
No.
Okay, good. So, the father is almost to die. What will happen to the kid? We are asking questions. And a stranger approaches to kid. He has two wife. He has wife and two children and a dog. You didn't watch the movie, but in the movie, in the middle of the movie, they heard a dog voice under the ground. That is why the boy trusted them. When he saw the dog, he understood their existence. He understand that they are good family, good people. So, but nevertheless, while watching, we are asking some other questions. Should he trust this man? Should the kid trust the man? Should he trust his family and go on walking with them? The boy encounters with good guys even under the worst conditions. People were eating each other. There were gangs around, roaming gangs, roaming bands. And the family from the beginning have been following this kid and his father. And this boy and family is hope of humanity, I think. Hope of humanity, even under the worst conditions. And that is why this is important scene. This is a miracle, I think. This is a miracle. You don't need to eat people. Even you are hungry. Okay? So we have to finish the lesson. There is one lesson to finish the course. I think next week we will have to another lesson, okay? Do you want to come here?
Sure.
Okay. And we can make a chat as well, okay? Just two pages, but I will show three or four movie scenes. Because it is heavy movie scenes. At the end of the course. Thank you.
Thank you.